Are you trying to figure out what Arduino you should buy? There are tons of different Arduino boards out there. Which one is best for you? By the end of this lesson, you'll be able to decide which Arduino is right for you, and you'll be able to buy with confidence. You'll also learn about the must-have accessories if you're planning on getting into Arduino. Finally, you'll get an invitation for a behind-the-scenes look at the Programming Electronics Academy membership training website. Stay tuned. If you go to the Arduino website and look at the boards at the store, they've got over 20 different boards listed. If you check Wikipedia, they list over 182 different Arduino compatible boards. Amazon.com has over 1,000 listings of the Arduino board, not to mention 51 different brands selling Arduino stuff. What gives? Which one are you supposed to get? Why are the names all so funky? And how do you know if the software is going to work for the one that you buy? Well, let me make this as clear and simple as possible. I'm going to cut through all of that noise, and I'm just going to tell you which Arduino you should buy for 99% of what you need to do. You ready for it? Buy an Arduino Uno Rev3. Rev3 stands for Revision 3. It's that easy. And here's why I can say that with confidence. First off, the Arduino is by far the most popular Arduino board out there. So if you're just getting started and you want to look at some example code that's out there, you're going to find tons of it available for the Arduino Uno. Reason number two, not only is there a ton of code available for the Arduino Uno, but most of the add-ons that you'll find for Arduino called shields are built to work with the Arduino Uno. Reason number three, for 99% of your needs, the Arduino Uno is going to do exactly what you need. The Uno has 20 separate input-output channels called pins, and all of those channels could be used to read digital on-off type inputs. 6 of those inputs can be used to read analog inputs, like if you were turning a knob. So for the lion's share of projects, that is going to be plenty of input-output options. So that's my recommendation. I would get an Arduino Uno Rev3, and I really think you'll be happy that you did. But come on, we need some exceptions to a rule, right? Okay, well, let me cover 2 cases where you might want a different Arduino board. Let's say that you've already got this predefined project that you have in mind, and you already know that you need tons of inputs or tons of outputs to make it work. If that's the case, you may want to check out the Arduino Mega 2560 Rev3. It's got 54 input output pins. That's almost 3 times that of the Uno. Now, the Arduino Mega works almost exactly like the Arduino Uno, so I would still recommend it if you're just getting started, but only if you're positive you need more input-output channels than what already comes with an Arduino Uno. Now, let's say you've got a project in mind that connects wirelessly to the internet. If that's the case, I would recommend getting a board that uses the ESP8266. 2 great options would be the Adafruit Feather Huzzah with ESP8266, or the SparkFun ESP8266 Thing development board. These boards are not technically Arduinos, but they can be programmed with Arduino code and in the Arduino IDE. They come with good code libraries for making connecting to the internet relatively simple, and if you buy from an established seller, they'll have a good working examples for you to start with. Interestingly enough, these Wi-Fi enabled boards are less expensive than an Arduino Uno. However, I wouldn't necessarily recommend these wireless boards if you're just getting started with Arduino. There is this very small yet very real level of complexity that makes these just ever slightly less user-friendly than your stock Arduino Uno. Now, maybe you like the idea of the Uno, but you're looking for a slightly different form factor. Maybe you need something that's really small. Well, you could check out a company called Tiny Circuits. They make super small Arduino boards. But here's the good news. Whatever Arduino board you buy, as long as it says compatible with Arduino, chances are that you're going to be just fine using it. That's kind of what's great about Arduino. The code you write on one board can be transferred to tons of different boards, usually with no changes or very minor changes to the code. So if you already have an Arduino board and you're wondering if you got the right one, you're probably fine. Now, one confusing thing about buying an Arduino Uno is that you'll find that there's many companies sell Arduino Uno clones. So if you didn't know, the company that came up with Arduino made their hardware design open source for people to use. It's called open source hardware. Kind of like open source software, except they are sharing the electrical design files instead of the actual code. So what this means is that there's tons of other companies that have taken the exact same design of the Arduino Uno and simply cloned it. Then they add a fancy name, often with the suffix Duino, and they say something like, hey, it's Arduino compatible. And in fact, in most cases, these clones are fully Arduino compatible. So they've got these reputable companies that do this. They sell clones of Arduino Uno. Now the boards have different logos on them, and sometimes they'll have slightly different features. But for all intents and purposes, they work great with the Arduino software and other Arduino shields. So should you buy an Arduino from the Arduino company, or should you buy a clone? Does it matter? Well, the Arduino you buy from Arduino.cc usually costs a little bit more, and the selling point of the clones is that they kind of cost less. Now, I'm not a sentimental guy by any stretch, but for your first Arduino board, I'd actually recommend buying your board from Arduino.cc or a certified distributor of Arduino. I say this because I think the Arduino company does good stuff like support the Arduino IDE. So in my opinion, it's supporting a good cause. But hey, it's your call. So let's switch gears now and talk about the must-have accessories if you're getting into Arduino. Now, before we jump into this, I don't recommend going out and buying everything you think you need to set up an electronics shop if you're just getting started into Arduino and electronics. It makes more sense to kind of gradually get stuff built up. But if all you bought was an Arduino board and no sensors or output devices to play with, it can be not quite as exciting. Okay, so the first thing you're going to need is a USB cable to connect your Arduino to your computer. Assuming you take my advice and you get an Arduino Uno, you'll need an AB type USB cable. This is the kind of cable that you use to hook a printer up to your computer. And since it's needed, I guess it's not really an accessory, but hey, it made the list. Now, if you bought a different style of Arduino board, you may want to make sure you have a micro USB cable hanging around, as that's a common type of connector for other boards. The next must-have accessory is an Arduino kit. And the reason I say this is because the prices have gotten so affordable on these kits that it really just doesn't hurt to have one laying around. Oftentimes, the buying of the individual components costs more anyway, so it can save you some time and a little bit of cash. Now, there's a ton of different kits out there. One way to pick a kit is to ask yourself what kind of project you have in mind. Maybe you can find a kit that already has some of the items that you need in the project anyway. I know trying to find specific components that you know will work with Arduino can sometimes be just a little bit intimidating, especially if you're just getting started. But if you buy those pieces as part of an Arduino kit, you can be pretty sure they're going to work just fine with Arduino. Now, you'll want to make sure the kit comes with a solderless breadboard. You use a solderless breadboard to make temporary electrical connections with different components. You'll also want to make sure that it comes with jumper wires, which are wires for making these temporary electrical connections. You'll want to ensure it comes with a handful of resistors and some LEDs, and these are mostly for building simple circuits to kind of play around with. Chances are, all those things I just mentioned are going to be part of a good Arduino kit. Now, an alternative to buying a kit with a bunch of different components is to buy an Arduino shield that has a bunch of components built into it. This is probably the best option for people who are maybe already into electronics, kind of familiar with simple circuits, and would rather focus on learning how to program the Arduino. Now, this is a bit of a shameless plug because our company happens to sell such a shield called a kit on a shield for Arduino. It has 15 pre-built circuits on it, so it kind of gives you this playground to mess around with when you're learning to program Arduino. Now, there's other companies that make similar kind of shields. You can check out Dr. Arduino. They make a really cool shield also. Well, I hope you're excited to get started with Arduino. It can really be a ton of fun and extremely satisfying to have programmed and built something yourself. If you want to jumpstart your Arduino programming skills, then you should check out our membership at Programming Electronics Academy. We offer many step-by-step training courses to get you started programming Arduino. If this sounds cool to you, then check out programmingelectronics.com/tour for a behind-the-scenes look at exactly what it's like to be a member. That's programmingelectronics.com/tour for a behind-the-scenes look at our training program. If you enjoyed this video, click the red button to subscribe to our YouTube channel and you'll get updates of the new lessons that we release. Well, hey, it's back over to you now. What's your favorite Arduino board? I'd love to hear what your thoughts are in the comments. Have a great day, and I'll see you in the next lesson. Bye.